In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And good morning. Good to be with you once again here at St. Patrick's in White Lake, Michigan. My name is Father Paul Graney, and let us approach the Lord today with humble hearts and grateful hearts for all that He has given to us and done for us, and acknowledge our sins to celebrate these mysteries more worthily. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
of the Lord where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am. You called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body, but the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. John was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what he had said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and you will see." So they went and saw where Jesus was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 in the afternoon. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Well, one of the questions that is always coming up in our lives, "God, what do you want me to do? Lord, what is your will? What do you want me to do with my life? What am I supposed to do in this situation?" And this weekend, the first reading from with Eli and Samuel is a great example of what discernment looks like, the process of it, understanding God's will, especially when it comes time to make some significant decisions in life. So in this reading, we have the young Samuel, and he's just sleeping. Nothing wrong with sleeping or taking naps. Naps are great. Naps are beautiful. But prophets in the Old Testament, they're not the biggest fans of taking naps, at least not when it comes to talking about spiritual things, because the theme of sleeping in the Bible, it's often not a good thing, because it signifies kind of like this inattentiveness. In the scenes where someone is asleep, they're often portrayed as not being awake or aware of spiritual wife. Not necessarily because of lack of effort or lack of goodness, because here in this story we hear is young Samuel. He obviously loves God, and he wants to be near to him by the fact that he himself went to the tabernacle and was asleep near the Ark of the Covenant. But at this point, he's just a boy, so he needs some help to know and understand God's voice, because he's inexperienced, and he is therefore spiritually asleep. God speaks to him here three times, and each time Samuel, he has no idea that it is God speaking to him. He hears a voice, but he thinks that voice is of his mentor, Eli. Samuel is mistaken, but mind you, he's a generally good kid. He loves the Lord, and he's faithful to his mentor, but his mentor, Eli, he eventually catches on what is actually going on with Samuel, and so he instructs him what to do and how to listen and respond to God's voice. I've been there. I'm sure all of you have been there. This story is a story that has happened countless times. God speaks to us, but we don't know what it is or what it means, or we just flat out miss that he is even speaking to us in the first place. I got to imagine that Jesus has knocked on my head an innumerable amount of times, and I had no idea it was him or that anyone was even knocking at all. And also, just think about communicating with people on a daily basis. Even the people that we know and love the most, the best, and see face to face on a regular basis, even with these people, there are times when there's just this miscommunication going on. So even the best human communication can be misunderstood. And then think about trying to understand and communicate with God, a person you can't see, a person you can't audibly hear with your ears. So it is a unique and challenging relationship at times. But we can be confident, though, that God, he loves us, and he's not going to ever get tired of us not understanding him. He doesn't get annoyed, he doesn't get frustrated, and he's never going to stop speaking to us. Jesus, he is very, very, very persistent. And when he calls to us, our response, we pray, is always going to be a response like Samuel's response, from the heart, genuine and open. As he said, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." The Bible records that Samuel prayed that prayer just one time, and he just kind of got it, right? He understood God very, very well. And I wish that were more the case more often for myself and for all of us, because usually our experience is we have to kind of really be persistent in our listening and quieting our lives down so we can hear that small, still whisper of a voice, and then not only kind of sense something's going on, but then like be able to, you know, understand it and then go about whatever he is trying to tell us. Also, we must be confident that understanding God's will, it's not just a one-sided effort by us. It's not like taking out a map and trying to decipher something outside of us. What's going on is that we're trying to understand and figure out a person who is speaking to us. The better that we know this person, the better the communication is going to be understood. And this person actually is not outside of us. He lives within us. It's a dialogue with a friend who has made his home in our hearts, and he intimately knows us, and he knows how to best reach us. And trust that God really does actually want us to know what he has in mind for our lives. He loves us, and he wants to take care of us, and he has also given us friends, family, his parish community at St. Patrick's, in order to help us figure out exactly what he's trying to say to us. And look at Samuel, young boy. He does not come to understand and know God's voice just completely on his own. There's Eli, his mentor. And we also will not come to know God's voice completely all on our own either. God doesn't want it to kind of work out like that. That's why he has established the church, the body of Christ, the community of his sons and daughters. Not a bunch of individuals, but a collection, a communion of people. So we learn from other people's experiences as they too draw closer to the Lord, and what has worked well for them and what hasn't worked well for them. And we all are helping each other out, so we don't go at the spiritual life alone in the least. So this new year, may we become more awake and pray and respond just as Samuel did. Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. Let us now proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As God's sons and daughters, let us now approach him with confidence and place before him our prayers.
For the needs of the Universal Church, St. Patrick Parish, and in particular for Patricia Freiberg. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us in God's holy church, may the Holy Spirit grant us courage and confidence in living as humble and holy disciples. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the conversion of all sinners, may the Lord lead all hearts to seek him and repent of their sins. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families who are wounded by division, separation, or divorce, may Christ bring them healing and forgiveness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of this worship community, may God strengthen us in faith and help us grow in charity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the hope of eternal life, may our Savior welcome them into the joy of his heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the homebound viewing this Mass, that all of their prayers will be answered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we are grateful for all that you have given to us. We ask you to help us to be able to better understand your voice and your direction that you want us to take in our lives. We ask these prayers and all the prayers we hold in our hearts. We ask them in the name of Jesus, your Son, who is Lord forever and ever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all the Holy Church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Alan our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offered for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Pray that everybody has a blessed week. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.